गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, दिस सेशन इज फॉर क्लास 12th। वी आर स्टडिंग चैप्टर 4, मैग्नेटिक फोर्स, और यू कैन से मैग्नेटिक इफेक्ट ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिक करंट। दिस इज द नेम ऑफ दिस चैप्टर। एंड स्टूडेंट्स, यस्टरडे वी कंप्लीटेड द टॉपिक मैग्नेटिक फोर्स ऑन अ करंट कैरिंग कंडक्टर। यू कैन सी ऑन द स्क्रीन, दिस वॉज द टॉपिक विच वी हैव कंप्लीटेड इन लास्ट सेशन। ओके, I hope you remember the formula for the force. So if you want to see, you can see the force here. This one is the formula for force. F is equal to NaL into QVD into B, where N is number of electron per unit volume in the conductor, A is area of cross section of the conductor, L is the length of the conductor, Q is the electronic charge. You can replace this Q by E. The value of this Q is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. Then this VD. VD is the average drift velocity of moving charged particle in the conductor. And B is, of course, the external magnetic field in which the current carrying conductor is placed. Okay. So this was the formula which we have derived yesterday. You can change this formula in different form. You can write this formula in terms of current density, area of cross section, length and external magnetic field. Also, you can write the same formula in terms of current flowing through the conductor, the length of the conductor and magnetic field. Now you know the concept of this cross. So you know that since this force is perpendicular to the plane containing magnetic field and the wire. Okay. Similarly, you can see here, this is the cross product. So this force is perpendicular to the both current density and magnetic field. Okay, if this force is acting at the very small portion of the conductor, then you can calculate the total force by summing this equation. Okay, so this one is the equation in summation form. So I hope you remember this formula, and in this form you can write this one, I dl b sin theta, because dl cross b will give you dl b sin theta n cap. In magnitude you can write I dl b sin theta, of course, because n cap is a unit vector, and when you try to find out magnitude of this vector, then the value of magnitude of n cap is 1. So in magnitude it will be F is equal to I dl b sin theta. So I hope you understand. And we have revised this term. Today our topic will be, you can see on the screen, this is the topic. This is motion in a magnetic field. So motion of charged particle in a magnetic field. Actually, this is our topic for today. So motion in a magnetic field means motion of charged particle in uniform magnetic field we are going to study here. So you can see in this picture, this is the picture, you can see here, this cross represents the magnetic field perpendicular to the plane of paper and inward. This is the symbol. If anywhere you see this type of symbol, it means the magnetic field is perpendicular and inward to the plane of paper. Now suppose this charge particle, suppose this one is a positive charge particle, it is moving in this magnetic field along positive x-axis. Okay, and the magnetic field is perpendicular and inward, you can say here, perpendicular and inward. So by applying Fleming's left hand rule, you can see the direction of force is along y-axis. Okay, so it means if you take an axis perpendicular to the plane of paper and outward as a positive z axis, so in here you can see that the velocity of charged particle is along positive x axis and the magnetic field is along negative z axis, because it is perpendicular and inward, whereas we are taking perpendicular and outward axis as a positive z axis. So the magnetic field is along negative z axis and velocity is along positive x axis. So according to Fleming's lift hand rule, the force on discharge particle is along positive y-axis. Okay, so this one is the direction of force. Similarly, you can see at this point, because force is acting along y-axis, discharge particle start moving along y-axis. It starts changing its velocity, and after some time it is moving along positive y-axis. But when it is along y-axis and magnetic field is same along negative z-axis, the force is along negative x-axis. So at each point of this track, you can see the direction of force is changing according to the Fleming's left hand rule. Since at all these point the force is perpendicular to the velocity of the particle, so the path which is traced by the charged particle is a circle, because it is the condition a perpendicular force always move a particle in a circular track. Okay, so if you understand this, let's read what is written here. So you can see here, we will now consider in general, in greater detail, the motion of a charge moving in a magnetic field. We have learned in mechanics class 11 book chapter 6 that a force on particle does work if force has component along or parallel to it. Okay? The direction of motion of particle in the case of motion of a charge in the magnetic field, the magnetic force is perpendicular to the velocity of the particle. Okay, so no work is done and no change in magnitude of the velocity. So you can see here, a perpendicular force cannot do any work and it cannot change velocity of a moving object. It is written in these lines, and these are the topic of class 11, circular motion. Okay, we have completed this topic in class 11, but we are revising here. If particle is moving along x-axis and force is along y-axis, it means this force cannot do any work on this particle, and this force cannot change the magnitude of this velocity. Okay, it cannot change magnitude of this velocity, so the magnitude of this velocity remains constant. So you can see here, notice that this is unlike the force due to an electric field QE. तो यहाँ पर ये बोल रहा है कि ये force QE जैसा नहीं है, क्योंकि QE जो force होता है वो electric field की direction में होता है, but this force is not in the direction of magnetic field. So this force is neither in direction of magnetic field nor in direction of velocity of object, but it is perpendicular to the both velocity and the magnetic field. So if velocity is in one direction and magnetic field in any other direction, so force is perpendicular to the both, it means it is perpendicular to the velocity and magnetic field. So which can have a component parallel or anti-parallel to the motion? This electric force can have a component parallel or anti-parallel to the motion, and thus can transfer energy in addition to momentum. तो क्योंकि ये जो फोर्स है, ये इलेक्ट्रिक फोर्स है, ये इलेक्ट्रिक फील्ड की डायरेक्शन में लगता है, तो इसके कंपोनेंट या तो पैरेलल या एंटी पैरेलल हो सकते हैं, जिससे कि ये या तो मोशन को एक्सेलरेट करेगा या डी एक्सेलरेट करेगा. इट मींस अगर एक्सेलरेट करेगा तो ट्रांसफ़र करेगा एनर्जी, एनर्जी ट्रांसफ़र होगी तो उसमें एडिशनल मोमेंटम होगा, क्योंकि उसकी वेलोसिटी चेंज होगी, इंक्रीज होगी. तो यहाँ पे देखते हैं, वी शैल कंसीडर मोशन ऑफ चार्ज पार्टिकल इन अ यूनिफॉर्म मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. द फर्स्ट कंसीडर द केस ऑफ वी परपेंडिकुलर टू द बी. फर्स्ट कंसीडर द केस, यू कैन सी हियर, वी इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द बी. यू कैन सी हियर, इन द फर्स्ट केस वेलोसिटी इज परपेंडिकुलर टू द मैग्नेटिक फील्ड. ओके, so the perpendicular force, that is QVB, you know that this is the force which a charged particle can experience in an external magnetic field. This is the force. Okay, this is the force on a charged particle in external magnetic field. So this force acts as a centripetal force and produces circular motion perpendicular to the magnetic field. The particle will describe a circle if V and B are perpendicular to each other. So you can see here the motion, it means the path on which this particle travel will be a circle if condition is if velocity is perpendicular to the magnetic field. So if velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, then charged particle moves on a circular track in magnetic field. Okay, you can see here. So the particle will describe a circle if V and B are perpendicular to each other, and this is shown in figure 4.5. This is the figure 4.5, and this is the, you can see, circular motion. Now you know that the necessary condition for circular motion is the requirement of the centripetal force. So the centripetal force for this circular motion is equal to this magnetic force. This is QBB. So in that case, you can write QBB is equal to MB square R. So we are going to study about that here. If you can see here, if velocity has component along B, this component remains unchanged, and as the motion along the magnetic field will not be affected by the magnetic field. So it is saying that if there is any component parallel to the magnetic field, so there is no effect of that component, because in the direction of, if velocity is in the direction of magnetic field, it does not exert any force on that particle. So you can see here, field will not be affected by magnetic field. The motion in plane perpendicular to B is as before a circular motion. Okay? Thereby producing a helical motion. You have already learned in earlier classes in 11th, if you can see here, if R is the radius of the circular path of the particle, then force, that is this force, it means this one is the centripetal force. This centripetal force is equal to mb square upon r. It's perpendicular to the path towards the center of the circle. This is always along the center of the circle. So we know the direction of the centripetal force, it is always toward the center of the circular track and is called the centripetal force. Okay. If the velocity V is perpendicular to the magnetic field B, the magnetic force is perpendicular to the both V and B and acts like a centripetal force, it has a magnitude QBB. If V and B are perpendicular, then you know that the force is equal to Q, then V cross B. Now V cross B is equal to VB if they are perpendicular to each other, because sine theta is equal to 1. So this is, you can see here, this Q V cross B is equal to Q VB in magnitude, because in magnitude the unit vector n cap becomes 1. So you can see here, this MV square upon R is equal to Q V cross B. It means this is equal to QBB if V and B are perpendicular to each other. It means theta between velocity and magnetic field is 90 degrees. So from this equation you can find out the value of R, that is the radius of the circular track. So if you rearrange this equation, you can write R is equal to MB upon QB, that is given by equation number 4.5. you can see here, equation number 4.5, this is very important. This is very important equation to find out the radius of the circular track, radius of the circular track on which the charged particle move in uniform magnetic field when enter in magnetic field at 90 degrees. Okay, so I hope you can solve questions based on this topic. You can see here, R is equal to MB upon QB, where M is the mass of the charged particle, V is the magnitude of the velocity, Q is the charge on that particle. It means if the particle is alpha particle, so you must take 2 times electronic charge. If it is proton, it means it is 1.6 into 10 to the power minus 19 coulomb. If it is electron, it will be same. But for other different charge particles, it can be different, okay. And B is the magnitude of external magnetic field which is applied by any external agency or in by using any external source. So you can find out the value of R, it means the radius of the circular track, by using this formula. So you can see here, this MB is the momentum, okay. So you can see R is proportional to P. From this equation you can write R is proportional to P, where P is the linear momentum. You can see here, this is very important, R is proportional to P and P is linear momentum of the particle. So if linear momentum is large, the path radius of the path will be large. You can see here. So sometimes the most important question is, prove that the radius of the circular track of a charged particle in uniform magnetic field is directly proportional to the momentum of the particle itself, okay. So this one is the question. If this question is there in the exam, you should solve this part. It means you must derive the equation number 4.5, and this proves that R is proportional to momentum of the particle, okay. Now if charged particle does not enter in magnetic field at an angle 90 degree, so suppose it enters in magnetic field at some angle theta, so there will be two component of the velocity. One of them is along the magnetic field and one is perpendicular to the magnetic field, okay. Let me repeat the statement, because this statement is very important for our next part of this derivation. Suppose if charged particle enters in magnetic field at an angle theta, so you can resolve that velocity into two perpendicular components, okay. One of them is along the direction of the magnetic field, whereas the second one is perpendicular to the magnetic field, okay. Now we know that the perpendicular component is always responsible for the circular motion of the particle, okay. If velocity and magnetic field are perpendicular to each other, then there will be a force which is responsible for the circular motion of the charged particle. It means this charged particle is again going to move on a circular track, but this charged particle has another velocity component which is along the direction of the magnetic field. Since there is no force along the direction of the magnetic field, it means the charged particle will move with the same velocity in the direction of the magnetic field. It means there is one force which is responsible for the circular motion of the charged particle and which is perpendicular to the both velocity and the direction of magnetic field, okay. But there is no force along the direction of magnetic fields, but there is velocity along the direction of magnetic field. So the charged particle will also move in a straight line. So can you imagine, one particle can move on a circular track and in a straight line together? Yes. So if you can imagine, the track will be like this. This one is known as helical path, or you can see the spring. So spring like structure is this. So in this, this one you can see the circular track, which is due to the perpendicular component of the velocity with the magnetic field, and this linear, you can see the linear motion. This is due to the parallel component of velocity along the magnetic field, okay. You can see in this diagram. So if magnetic field along this direction, you can see the particle has velocity at some angle theta. This one is theta. So you can resolve this velocity V parallel to magnetic field and this perpendicular to magnetic field. This perpendicular component is responsible for the circular motion, whereas this parallel component is responsible for the straight line motion. So by combined effect of these two, velocity the resultant path, the resultant path of the motion of the charged particle in magnetic field is helix. Okay, in general you can say it is like spring. You have seen spring, so you can see there is straight line movement with the circular turns. Okay, so you can see here. Now if it is moving on a circular track, you can find out its frequency, its angular velocity, its time period. So let's solve for that. So you can see here, the larger the momentum, the larger the radius and bigger the circle described. We have already discussed this part. Let's start from here. If omega is the angular frequency or angular velocity, you can say, then we can write V is equal to omega r, since you know that omega is the linear velocity. Sorry, V is linear velocity, omega is angular velocity, and r is radius. So relation among V, omega, and r is V is equal to omega r. You know about this. So where omega is known as the angular frequency, so you can write omega is equal to 2 pi into frequency. This is known as nu. You can write f here. So you can also write here v upon r. So you can find out the value of v upon r from this equation. So you will get v upon r is equal to qb upon m. This is the angular frequency of the charged particle, because charge of the particle is known, magnetic field is external, so it is known, and m is the mass of the charged particle, it is known. So in terms of known physical quantity, you get omega. This is the angular frequency. Okay, now if you know angular frequency, then you can find out the time period. That is, time period is t is equal to 2 pi omega, 2 pi upon omega, you know about this. And similarly frequency, that is 1 by f is equal to frequency. So from this formula, from this equation 4.9, you can calculate the angular frequency, then time period, then frequency, then different type of other unknown quantities according to the question. Okay, so you can see here, which is independent of the velocity or energy. You can see here, this equation is independent of the velocity or energy. Here nu is frequency of the rotation. The independent of nu from energy has important application. The independence of nu from the energy has important application in designing of cyclotron. Okay, so this independence condition becomes the principle of design a cyclotron. Students, cyclotron is a device which is used to accelerate a charged particle to very high velocity, except electrons. Okay, this cyclotron is not used to accelerate very light charged particle like electrons, but these are used to accelerate heavier charged particle like proton, alpha particle, which have slightly higher mass. Okay, why this cyclotron cannot accelerate very light particles like electron, we will discuss later this topic in detail. You can see here the time taken for one revolution, that is known as the time period, can be calculated by the equation 4.6, and it is 2 pi by omega, and this is equal to the 1 by frequency. You know that the number of revolution in 1 second is known as the frequency. So this t is reciprocal of frequency. From this equation you can see, if there is a component of velocity parallel to the magnetic field, denoted by this parallel. So you can see here, this velocity component is parallel to the magnetic field. Okay, so denoted by V parallel, it will make the particle move along the field, and path of the particle would be helical. So we have already discussed this is actually the helical path, because this velocity has two components. One of them is perpendicular to the magnetic field, and second one is a parallel to the magnetic field. Okay, so the distance moved along the magnetic field in one complete rotation is called the pitch. So student, when this charged particle started its motion from this point, when it complete one rotation, it travels some distance in straight line. So you can see here this linear distance. This linear distance is known as pitch. Okay, this is known as pitch or denoted by P. So this pitch is given by the time taken in one complete rotation. This is the time into velocity in parallel to the magnetic field. Okay, because in this direction there is no acceleration, so we can use formula velocity into time. So in this direction velocity is constant, and that is V cos theta. So V cos theta into time period. So time period can be calculated from here. So you can write P is equal to, that is pitch is equal to V parallel or V cos theta into T. So you can replace this T by this formula, and if you replace the value of omega by QB by M, you will get this relation. So you can see here 2 pi M by QB, where V parallel can be replaced by V cos theta. So the radius of the circular component, or you can say the radius of the circular component of motion, is called the radius of the helix. So you can calculate the radius of helix by this formula, but this V will be replaced by V sin theta, because you can see here this V perpendicular component is not V, but it is V sin theta. So in case of helix, the radius is given by R is equal to MV sin theta by QB. Okay, so this radius can be calculated by, when it is enters at an angle theta, the radius is something different, and it will be equal to MV, that is MV sin theta, where theta is the angle between velocity and the magnetic field, sin theta upon QB. MV sin theta upon QB. This is the formula by which you can calculate the radius of this circular track on which this charged particle is moving on a helical path in this magnetic field. Okay, so I hope you understand. If this charged particle enter at an angle 90 degree, it will move on circular track with radius r, and this radius is given by the formula, that is r is equal to mv by qb. But if the same charge enters in magnetic field not at an angle 90 degree but any angle theta except 90 degree, suppose it is 45 or 30 or 60, like that, so the radius of the circle, actually it will move on a helical track. So in that helical track, the radius of the circular part is given by r is equal to mv sin theta by qb, and the distance, that is linear distance traveled by the particle in one complete rotation, is known as the pitch, and this pitch is given by v parallel into time period, where v parallel is v cos theta, and the value of time period can be calculated by this equation omega. From here you can find out the value of t, and that will be here. So you can replace this v parallel by v, you can replace this v parallel by v cos theta. Okay, so from here you can see there is, similarly you can write this pitch p is equal to, you can write this value as 2 pi m, then v, then cos theta, cos theta, because it is along the magnetic field, so this one is cos theta by, this one is upon q into b. So this v parallel is actually is equal to v cos theta. Okay, so by this equation you can find out the value of pitch when a charged particle enter in magnetic field at an angle theta. So I hope you understand the concept. So this topic was the motion of charged particle in magnetic field, and the most important result of this topic is, if it charged particle enter in magnetic field, its path will be circular, and radius is given by this equation number 4.5. If this charge particle enter in magnetic field at some angle theta, then its path will be helical and its radius will be given by this formula, that is mv sin theta by qb, where theta is angle between velocity and magnetic field, and its pitch is given by 2 pi mv cos theta by qb, pitch means the linear distance traveled by the charge particle in complete rotation. Okay, so I hope you understand this topic. Thank you for watching. Keep studying. Students, try to solve questions based on this topic, then only you will be able to understand the concept more deeply. Okay, thank you for watching.